Assalamu alaikum viewers. Welcome to Siyasat English News. I'm Aiman Umar. After successfully organizing the Sunday Fun Day event on Tank Band Road, Motit in the month of September, the Telangana government is now mulling to initiate a similar event at the Charminar area. Municipal Administration and Urban Development Principal Secretary Arvind Kumar on Monday tweeted the same, asking Hyderabad Lok Sabha MP Asaduddin Owaisi regarding his thoughts on the idea. In September, Telangana Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development, K.T. Rama Rao, launched the Sunday Fun Day, which aims to be a recreational event for the people of Hyderabad. Tank Band's new facelift for the weekend has enthralled residents of the city, who have been pleasantly surprised by the number of activities the area now has to offer. Sunday Fun Day has been so far a major hit among the people. A blood donation camp was organized by the Hyderabad Traffic Police to help women and children of Niloufar Hospital. Nearly 250 police officials have registered for the blood donation. Anjani Kumar, the city commissioner, have told ANI, the traffic police and Niloufar Hospital is organizing a blood donation camp at Red Rose Function Hall in Abbots. This camp is organized for the children who are in need of blood at the hospital, and so far over 250 traffic police officials have registered for the cause. The event was organized by Shikha Goyal, Additional Commissioner of Police of Crime, DCP Traffic Chauhan and DCP of Traffic Karunakar Bhaskar and other officers. Hyderabad International Airport recorded the highest passenger footfall of nearly 48,000 on 9th of October. These include both domestic and international passengers. Before the COVID pandemic hit the operations in March last year, the airport was handling about 60,000 passengers daily. The airport also reached 350 air traffic movements, which is 77% of the pre-COVID numbers. With the number of COVID cases steadily coming down across India and the confidence in travel is gaining momentum, the average domestic passengers traveling from Hyderabad Airport per day rose to 31,137 in September as compared to 22,500 per day in July. According to the operator, GMR Hyderabad International Airport Limited, the airport saw an increase in the number of flights across domestic sectors as well. The airport recorded a substantial rise in the ATMs in September, which was close to 9,000. The Telangana Secondary School of Education, for the second time in a row, has decided to have only 6 question papers instead of 11 for the ensuing secondary school certificate exams for the present academic year. The Department of Education has issued official orders on Monday for reducing the number of question papers from 11 to 6. The changes were made for the relief of students due to the COVID-19 pandemic and the subsequent disruption of the academic atmosphere, including the disruption of regular classes. It means students have to write only one paper for each subject instead of 2 papers in the existing format. Meanwhile, for the benefit of students, the authorities have also issued orders that Urdu is being considered as a second language for this year. With this, the students can have an option for the second language between Hindi, Urdu and Telugu. The exams are likely to be held in March and April in 2022. Videos of right-wing groups forcibly shutting down meat shops in Haryana, Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh have gone viral on social media. These groups have also demanded that the shops should remain closed during the 10 days of the Navratri festival, which is being celebrated from 7th to 15th of October. Apart from it, they want the shops to remain closed every Tuesday as well. Recently, Uttar Pradesh Bajrang Dal members have submitted a memorandum to Tehsil headquarters demanding authorities to ensure that all meat shops remain closed during the Navratri festival. In the memorandum, the district convener of Bajrang Dal, Harish Kaushik, said that in case meat shops continue to remain open, members of the group will be forced to take to the streets. Later, the members of right-wing groups are seen forcibly closing the meat shops. A 33-year-old United Arab Emirates-based Indian expatriate visited 100 pavilions at Expo 2020 Dubai in the mega event within 5 days. Blesson Thankachan hails from Kerala and works as a service delivery manager in UAE. Instead of going home to India for his annual holidays, Thankachan used his annual leave to go on a world tour without hopping on a plane. Thankarchan started the tour from day 1 of the Expo 2020 Dubai, that is 1st of October, and made his way through 100 country pavilions from Lithuania to Lebanon and Switzerland to Singapore, all in just 5 days. On the first day, he covered 18 countries, starting with the UAE and Saudi Arabia pavilions. The next 4 days, he managed to get stamps from each of the 100 countries he visited out of 200 plus country pavilions. Expo 2020 Dubai is the first international exhibition to be organized in the Middle East. Superstar Amitabh Bachchan, on his 79th birthday on Monday, announced that he has terminated his contract with a Pan Masala brand, saying that he wasn't aware that it falls under surrogate advertising. A statement issued on behalf of Amitabh Bachchan read, "Kamala Pasand, a few days after the commercial was aired, Mr. Bachchan contacted the brand and stepped out of it last week." The statement from Amitabh's office further read, "Mr. Bachchan has terminated the contract with the brand, has written to them his termination and has returned the money received for the promotion." The move comes after the megastar had been requested by a national anti-tobacco organization to withdraw himself from the campaign, which promoted Pan Masala, saying that it would stop the youth from getting addicted to tobacco. That's it for today. Thank you, viewers.